B'Shem Hashem Na'aseh V'Nasliach. We're learning Netivot Shalom, explanation on Torah, Sefer Devarim Parashat Shoftim at Kolel Bet Aharon. Bekatav lo et Mishneh Torah, that a king, a Jewish king, needs to write for himself the Torah. Som Tassim Melech, Som Tassim Alecha Melech, that the Pasuk commanded us to appoint a king and etc. Rag loyi belo susim, beloyi belo nashim, that only that king should not have lots of horses and should not have lots of wives.
The
kesef zahav and silver and gold loyir belo meod should not be allowed to him. Vehaya keshvato ad kise memalchoto, and when he sits on his chair and the crown of the kingship, vekatav lo et mishneh haTorah hazot, and he needs to write for himself this Torah, referring to Chamisha Chumshe Torah. The Amru Chazal and our rabbis of blessed memory teach us in Masechet Sanhedrin, Chaf Aleph Amud Bet, the Pirush Mishneh Torah, that what is the explanation of the Mishneh Torah? Shetei Sifrei Torot, that he must write two complete Chamisha Chumshe Torah, the Sefer Torah. Achad Shemonachad lo bebet Ginzav,
in house of treasury.
Right, that one he needs to put it in his house, in the palace. And another one that he goes out with it when he goes out, and when he comes into the palace, he still has it, which has to be on his arm. Well, avodah yesh lomar sheparashat zo shel melech gai gam al ma'an malchei labanan. So the rule is that Torah is eternal, and all its lessons is always applicable, and therefore this lesson should be applicable to us as well, and even nowadays that we don't have a king. Ubetechila nemeru beparashat zo inyane sur mera lo yirbelo susim shebaze mitpata igar hakoach. As the pasuk says, lo bigvurat hasur sikhpas. So in the beginning of this parasha, it tells us that distance yourself from bad sur mera, right? Vasetov. What is the sur mera? Sur mera is that a king should not have too many wives, should not have too many horses, not so much, gold. Money, gold, and silver, and all that. And therefore, lo yibelo susim, hayinu shelo yasim, mibetcho bekoach gashmi, that do not give your bitachon, do not give your belief. Do not have your belief system based on the power of your horses. Don't rely on mundane and physical aspects of your life so much. Ella iftach rach ba'agadosh ba'Hashem itparach. Rather, only rely on Hashem. Right. Hashem is your soul savior, and He is going to save you. Only and only Hashem. Velo yibelo nashim, and don't have too many wives.
Shakua,
that if you have too many wives, then they come and they indulge you. Mm-hmm. They keep you busy with so much of desires. The case of zahav lo yibelo meod, as the pasuk says, lahalan levilti rom levavo ma'achav, that if you have too much, gold and silver, also they will take your heart away, your attentions away from your brothers. Ki al yedekesef ve zahav yarom levavo me'achav, ואחר כך נאמר בנוגל עשה טוב, and then later on it tells us about the good things that the king needs to do. עשה טוב, do the good things. והיה כשבתו על כיסא ממלכתו וכתב לו עד משנה התורה הזאת, that when you're sitting on your on your throne, what is it?
On your crown.
On your crown, it has to, you need to write the whole Torah. Ve'ayta imo, and it should be with you. Ve'garabo, and you should read it. Kol yemei chayav. All of your life. Le'man ilamed, that you should learn fear. Inyan, shenei sifrei Torah, achad shehi, munachad bebayt. Bebayt.
גנזב,
סורי, גנזב ואחד שנכנסת ויוצאת עמו מרומז לשתי דרכי ההנהגה. That which it says that Melech, a king, has to have two Torahs, and one in the palace and one with him, is referring to two ways of
behavior.
כשהו בינו לבין עצמו ובסעתו ובאו בין אנשים. When two behaviors, that when you are with yourself, you are alone, and when you are with others. הספר תורה בבית גנזב מרומז כדברי ערמה בראש שולחן בשולחן ערוך. That having ספר תורה at your home refers to that which Rema tells us in the beginning of Shulchan Aruch. Halakha. Shegam ke asher adam levado, that even when a person is alone with himself at his home, bebeto, yasim et libo shamelech hagadol hakadosh baruch hu asher male kol haaretz kevodo omed alav veroe bemaasav, that even if a king is alone at home,
not if the king, the person.
No, I'm sorry, a person is alone at home, he needs to think about Hashem. He needs to think and understand that Hashem is watching him, and Hashem is seeing all of his actions. Ve'im isater ish b'mestarayim v'ani lo aranu ne'om Hashem. That which the pasuk says, that if a person might think, I go and I hide in, you know, where there is so much reeds, among the reeds, perhaps Hashem would not see me. How is that possible? How can Hashem would not see you? Hashem is Malek Yavodo. Hashem's glory is everywhere. Hashem's Shekhinah is everywhere. That's different to having Sefer Torah in your storage, in the palace, in the treasury. שכה אשר הוא לבדו בביתו יודע תמיד כי הקדוש ברוך הוא אומר אדם, that when you are at home, you need to understand that Hashem is watching you. The king, when you are at the palace, you need to understand that your actions are being monitored by Hashem. וספר תורה שיוצא ונכנסת עמו עניינו כל סדר הליכותו של תלמיד חכם כדי איתה בחז"ל. And that which it says, that the Sefer Torah has to be on the arm of a king, wherever he goes, he should have it. That refers to a Talmid Chacham, that when a Talmid Chacham goes out in places, Umevuar Rambam, and as also Rambam explains in Halachot De'ot, Ech alav leitaneg b'machalo u'b'mishnitu ובמשתהו ובדברו ובכל עניינו הגשמים. That Rambam explains that how you act in your work, how you act when you eat something or in your speech or anything that is mundane. שיהיה מסעו ומתנו באמונה. That all of your work, right? Business has to be with everything has to be with emuna. Bezehu bebechinat, asefet Torah sheyuse Shiyosed v'nichneset imo. That refers to the Sefer Torah that a king
goes out
and comes into the palace with it. That wherever he goes, he makes Hashem's name sanctified, like a Talmid Chacham, that he needs to act right wherever he is. ועוד יש לומר עניין משנה תורה על פי the so the explanation of the Mishnah Torah is based on the pasuk כשם שיש 60 רבועה אותיות לתורה כנגד 60 רבועה נשמות ישראל. Right, just like that there are Shishim Ravua, right? Otiot, the Torah, there are 600,000
letters
in the Torah. So too, there are 600,000 neshamot in Israel.
Keneged,
corresponding to. So to the 600,000 explanations
to the Torah.
Based on the Torah. Meyuchad le Torah. Bechol derachav. Wow. Therefore it comes out that every neshama, every Yehudi
has his own pirush.
That is uniquely his. That ed yedu'o v'tachfido be'olamo, which also that could be the whole essence of his creation, to come to be mechadesh, that's a chidush. O mekoach ze nishmat adam telamedenu shemehechen yoda'at haneshama ele shenoret hi
shenaket
hi la'pirush shela betorah. And that could be understandable that the neshama is getting to that level of explaining of that Torah, and that would give him sustenance to come and to say that pirush of the Torah. Vezeu inyan asifre Torah shemonechad lo bebet genazav. That is referring to the Sefer Torah inside of the palace of the king. Bet Genazav merumaz the Sefer Torah shel neshama. Bet Genazav is referring to the Sefer Torah of the neshama, hapirush hamuyuchad betorah shayach elav. That this pirush
explanation
of the on certain things is only for that particular neshama. Ha Sefer Torah sheyoseh v'nichneset imo hu sha Sefer Torah hakelali hanoga lechol klal Israel. And the Sefer Torah that the Yehudi, that the Melech goes out with it, that is referring to the Sefer Torah of all the Am Israel. Hainu shema'an malchei rabbanan serichi malchei rabbanan serichim sheyu lahem tamid shnei sifrei haTorah. همه در رخیم یهودی به خول اینیاناو اپراتیم و اکلالیم. And therefore a king always must have two Torahs, one of his own conducts and one that he is responsible to the Klal Israel, to the Klal Israel, that everything that he does and everything that people do, he needs to watch to make sure that they are on the right path. And that king must read the Torah all the days of his life. Who? That's the understand. That's the prepare. That's on the explanation of the pasuk is Tiferet Shlomo leva'el zot al pi Ma'amar Chazal. That the Tiferet Shlomo explanation on this is based on the מסכת ברכות דף ה עמוד א. אם רואה אדם שיסורים באים עליו יפשפש במעשיו. If a Yehudi sees that hardship is coming upon him, he needs to
Yisurim. It's not hardship.
Yisurim.
Yisurim is
hardship. Hardship, right? Hardship is coming on a person. He needs to search his conducts. He needs to make sure what he needs to find what's wrong. Pishpesh velo masa isla bebitul Torah. If he, you know, searched and find out that there was nothing wrong, couldn't find nothing wrong, then he should know that the Yisurin is bitul Torah, is that he perhaps did not learn Torah enough, right? The mashkim was there haregam bitul Torah hu chet, that the not learning Torah is chet by itself. The mashkim was there haregam bitul Torah hu chet. Umaze pishpesh velo masa im yeshbo chet shel bitul Torah. And what is it that he didn't? He searched and he didn't find that it should be bitul Torah. Meva'er atratenu hakadusha hi hamelamed el yehudi sheyoda shechet venotenet bo hakarat hachet, that a yehudi that he knows there is something wrong, and he comes to recognize that is wrong. It says in Zohar HaKadosh, right? Lo hodiya alav chata'o, o hodiya alav chata'o, chata'to, that you should inform him of his mistake. Man qam modea le irata qa modea le choviya. Modiya ha, so tell him, right? Inform him of his mistake and inform him of his obligations. Koach haTorah modiya liYehudi shechata. The power of the Torah is that once a person comes and he learns Torah, right, he will come to understand what there is that he's lacking. Yeah. In other words, if you don't learn Torah, you don't know what's wrong with you. A person needs to learn Torah to know what's wrong. If he doesn't learn Torah, then he thinks that he's the most righteous person in the whole world. By the way, I have had people who looked at me in face and told me, Rabbi, I am the most righteous.
I'm a tzaddik.
I'm a tzaddik, seriously. And unfortunately, those people are the most uneducated people.
But they are studying.
That's what they say. They say this.
They are not educated.
They don't understand who the tzaddik is. They can't identify themselves to the true tzaddik. So they think what they do is good enough. Right? Ki beli koach haTorah einenu yodea bichlal shechat. Without having the power of Torah, you don't know what's wrong. Vayeser hara masayet enyano lechashuv shenohik nachon. And the yeser hara comes and it closes your eyes, right, to think that everything you do are proper. Rag koach haTorah megale lo shiyodechet. Only the power of Torah can reveal to your mistakes. The Chachamim said that look into the Torah. HaTorah meira enav shel Yehudi. The Torah opens up the eyes of a Jew. Sheke Hashem.
It doesn't open
yet.
It lights up.
Meira, it lights up. Yeah.
Kasher yichte.
Sheke Hashem yichte mit orerim bo yesurei mesafon. She'einam notenim lo manuach. That when a person does not keep Torah, then Hashem sends the difficulties that he should not be at peace.
Bezeu giving peace.
Right, he's not having peace. Right. Bezeu pirush pishpesh. That is the explanation of searching in your deeds. Velo masa. Then you should know that it's bitul Torah. She'at Torah shelema ha'ita bebitul. Kemish ena shelo haita be kedusha va aruya umishom kach ena Torah megale lo et chatav. That because this Yehudi did not search, did not know Torah, he doesn't know what's wrong. Vezehu pirush hapasuk vegarabu kol yemei chayav, that Melech has to learn Torah all of the days of his life. She'at Torah hu lomed meemida befanav et kol yemei chayav umegale lo et kol ma she'asa bahem shelo kehogen. That he requires to learn Torah to know all of the all of his life that what is right and what is wrong, that he should fix himself. That HaKadosh Baruch Hu has given this power to a Jew, Kedei Shelo Yiste Min HaDerech, that he should not go off from the path. The Oraita Ga Modia Le Leheker Chatarato, that Torah would inform you of your mistakes. וזה הכוח שיש למען מלכי רבנן, שבכוח התורה גרה בה את כל ימי חייו, לבל לשכח מה שיעשה בהם שלא כהוגן. So that only through the power of Torah one could understand what is wrong, what is right, and that he should correct it. ברוך ה' לעולם, אמן.